Welcome to the class. We'll be doing partial differential equation. So we'll be starting with formation of partial differential equation. Before that, I would like you to see these things. This notation, del z by del x is p, will be denoted by p, del z by del y will be denoted by q, del 2z by del x square is denoted by r and s and t respectively. So what does it mean? In a differential equation, if you have x, y, z, then z will be the dependent variable and x and y are the independent variable. And this is the second order derivative of z with respect to x, and this is the second order derivative of z with respect to x and y. And this is the second order derivative of z with respect to y. So with this, we have already done what is the order and what is the degree of a partial differential equation. So what we'll do is we'll do the formation of differential equation, and the first method we are going to do is the eliminate by eliminating constant. It's an algebraic equation of this form x square plus y square plus c minus z minus c whole square equal to a square is given. From this, you have to see and you have to have an idea that x and y are the independent variable and z is the dependent variable, and c and a will be constants. Okay, this is the first thing. So whenever you see a equation where x, y, z are present, z will be a dependent variable, x and y are independent variable if it is not stated, and other constant will be the arbitrary constant. So we have to eliminate this constant by using different partial derivative and try to form the equation. So we'll do the first example. So here is the equation, and first of all, first thing is that you have to name this equation as equation number one. Next, you differentiate equation one. Differentiate f p r e n. Differentiate one partially. With respect to x, we get, so wait, differentiate this thing with respect to x, so this will be del by del x of all thing x square plus y square z minus c whole square equal to del y del x of a square. Okay, so now difference, this will be exactly like this normal derivative will go inside of y square plus del y del x of z minus c whole square equal to del y del x. I can just do this derivative because a square is constant, so del by del x of a square, because d by d, you know that d by dx of c is equal to 0, so therefore this will be del by del x of a square is 0. Similarly, now what is the d by dx of x square? So it is twice x plus derivative of y square with respect to x. Okay, y is the independent variable, this is different, so this will act as a constant, so this is 0. Plus, now del by del x of z minus c. You see, we are differentiating z with respect to x. So, z is a dependent variable, so inside z there is x also. Therefore, this derivative is not equal to 0. So, we have to use chain rule, so del by del x of this thing will be, using chain rule, this will be 2 z minus c. Again, derivative of this will be what? Del by del x of z minus c. This is equal to 0. Now, got what? 2x plus 2 z minus c. Del by the del z by del x, this will remain like this, del z by del x, and derivative of c is 0. So this is our equation number 2. Now you observe this equation, you have one constant C here. Okay. So C is not removed, but we have a C here. So okay, so that's why this is the first part. Now again differentiate one partially with respect to y. We have, so you'll have del y del y of x square plus y square plus z minus c whole square equal to del y del y of a square. So you differentiate this, so del y del x del y of x square plus del y of y square plus del y of z minus c whole square is equal to zero. Now del y del x, because we are differentiating with respect to y, so x will be constant, so this will be zero. Plus del y of y square will be twice y. Plus again, z is the independent variable, y is independent variable, so you have to use chain rule, similar to that of the earlier example. This is this del y of z minus c is equal to zero. Now this zero, I will just not write it. So twice y plus, so what will be this? Twice z minus c, and this will be del z by del y. This is equal to zero. Now this is equation number 3. Now from 2 and 3, you have to eliminate this c. Okay. So what was 2? By the way, 2 was a 2x is plus 2z minus c del z by del x is equal to 0. So that was equation number 2. There is equation number 3. So from this 2, I have to eliminate c. So how are you going to do it? So there is many ways to do it. So let's, before doing this, let's put this 2 also here. After 2, I think I should have written this. This is like this. Okay. Z minus c. So in place of del z by del x, I'll put a small p equal to 0. So this will be our equation number 2. And this is not our equation number 3. Our equation number 3 will be what? 2y plus 2z minus c. In place of del z by del y, I'll write q. So this is equal to 0. So this is 2. So from this 2 and 3, we have to eliminate this one, this c term. So how are you going to do it? So it's up to you, they are equal, right? So how are you going to do it? So I can do something like this. From 2, I think I'll just write it. So say you have a z minus c term here, you have a z minus c term here, you try to find out what will be the expression for z minus c from one equation and put it in the second one. So from here, we'll get z minus c. Okay, this thing is equal to 2y by q, right? 2q. So 2 will get cancelled, so y by q. So from here also, I can cancel 2. This is not important. Okay, 2 got cancelled. So there is the equation. So I'll write this is not. I'll write this thing as 3, and putting z minus c in 2, so what you'll get? X plus, in place of z minus 2, we have y by q, and you have a p here, is equal to 0. So I'll just write this equation as x cube plus yp equal to 0. So you see, this is a partial differential equation. Okay, this partial differential equation is same as what? Is same as x by del z by del y plus y del z by del x equal to 0. So you can write this equation or this equation. Okay, so this is the one required PDE, this one or this one. Okay, whatever it is, you can write anyone. But in PDE, we try to write the equation in this form. I've done a mistake here, there should be a minus here. So it shouldn't be plus, it will be minus. So this will be minus, and this will be minus. Okay? What is it? Okay, anyway, we can just, I think you will get it.